What up, guys? Alchemist100 here, playing some more WWE 2K17 Universe Mode. We're here at Pure Test Wrestling's episode 254 of Universe Mode altogether. We're here at Liverpool, England for the UK tour, and we're starting this night off with a tag team match. Sorry about the weird start. Sorry about the last episode too. Like I said, it was just fucking weird as hell. It sucks to have to redo this episode because of the way things are going. In the end, it is what it is, and you gotta make the best of it. Watch this. Oh! Right, this tag team match is starting off. And, just a weird night altogether. And then recording has been weird for me. You guys know how stuff's been going, especially with streams and things of that sort. So it's been kind of just a little rough to get into recording as a whole once again. But I am happy to be back. Oh, Japanese arm drag there. Now Kevin Surge and El Dinamite are a weird team, a weird mix of a team for sure, but they agreed to this match. I mean, they didn't have to. They really didn't have to. They said they want to try. They want to at least try and see what they can do. Gets a formidable tag team like Chuck White and Travis Young, who were former Pure Intense Wrestling tag team champions. I know, Dinamite getting something going, but gets cut off ever so quickly. You see Kevin Surge trying to cheer on El Dinamite here. And now Travis Young, enters the mix. This is to keep this, getting this thing done quickly. Reverses out of that. Dinamite ever so quick to get things going, his back, his pace, and especially on his back of his neck with that elbow there. Scoop slam, beautifully done. Heavy scoops him at that. And already up to the top is Dinamite here. Let's see this make turn things around for his team. He's taunting Travis Young to get up. I don't know if he can at this point. That slam was hard. That slam was harsh as well. Oh! The submission hold being locked in here. Modified STF. Maybe a little too early in this match regardless. Oh, the fact that he locked it in was big enough. Oh, just playing dirty once again. And you expect that from a guy like Kevin Surge or something. But that's not what you're getting here. You're getting a fucking rude Travis Young and Chuck White doing whatever the hell they want to do, playing the games the way they play them. And right now, look at this. Half a Nelson suplex there. Breaking them down once again. Now, as these universe modes start to go on, you've been wondering, what's up with the tag team division? And I know some of you guys may be asking, what's up with the tag team division? I really don't know what to tell you, to be honest. It's a lot going on. There's a lot going on. And one, two, no. Throws that shoulder up. But tag division's been picking up and slowing down. There's always new tag teams being made. I mean, look at this Kevin Surge and El Dinamite thing going on right here. There's a lot going on. And speaking of a lot going on here, watch this, big time DDT there. Crosscoming, this is awesome. And yes, it is. Ladies and gentlemen, this is amazing. Watch this. Oh, he just stomped. Almost he's stomping him in the spine there. Dinamite falls hard. Travis Young got taken out with that fucking DDT there from that middle rope. So smashes his head off the fucking. Afraid of six here. Oh. Oh, he swatted this man punch away. These guys need to get back in the ring. Oof. Look at this. No way. Go. And they just cheated to win. Kevin Surge wanted to, you know, Kevin Surge wanted to help. I don't think he knew exactly what to do. And like I said, the guy's more used to the single type matches. So you got a guy like El Dinamite that's also used to the single type matches as well. And spent a few times in tag teams, but just didn't happen tonight. You saw him toss him back in the ring respectively. But Chuck White was there to cut him off that belly to back suplex. And these two have just won a tag team match over via countout. You didn't expect it, but that's what happens here in Pure Intense Wrestling. Anything can happen. And as cheap as you guys may have thought this had been, may have been, it is what it is. In the end, these two may be just going right back in to become tag team champions once again. It'd be something amazing to see, but we'll find out soon enough. Anyway, guys, up next, we got some watching for you guys here on Pure Intense Wrestling. Benjamin James takes on Joe Hellenic. Benjamin James with the experience advantage. Joe Hellenic with the least, a little bit less experience advantage. Regardless of such, these guys are damn good at what they do. You see the size of Joe Hellenic there. You see the size of Benjamin James. James has the technical advantage in this one, where Joe Hellenic would have the power advantage. And you're already seeing that happen in this one. And that back elbow is a start for something there. Both guys are very quick at this in the striking game. At the same time, these guys are part of the top prospect tournament. Oh! Rolling forearm reversed. Oh, big enough clothes on it out of nowhere. And the quickness this guy can bring ever so quickly is what really can take Benjamin James off his game. But if anyone can really get around a guy like Joe Hellenic, it may be just Benjamin James. Regardless of such, now look at this. Going for a scoop slam sock, coming a mile away. Turns into a neck breaker, takes him down to the ground. Benjamin James showing off a little bit, but needs to keep his head in this match. And like I said, has the experience advantage. So he knows what the hell he's doing. Oh, Hellenic, big time reversal there. And keeping Benjamin James grounded. Shots after shots there. Oh, another one. Clobbering shot. Oh. Just anything that he can, any kind of strike he can land on James right now, definitely going to get, oh. Can definitely end this match for Benjamin James early. Hellenic's showing off a little too much. He's a focus on Benjamin James here. The guy is quick as all hell, I'm telling you. But Benjamin James really hasn't found a way to get himself off the ground as of yet. Ever since Hellenic found that big time reversal. I don't know, we're countering over that Coming into that fucking body press as he tried to pick him up for the belly-to-back suplex. And everyone, which one of these guys will be going on next week in the Top Prospect Tournament? Will it be one of these guys to make it all the way to the end and win the thing? I mean, that'd be fucking amazing to see. And I'd love to see either of these guys take on a guy like James McGalloway. The way McGalloway has his own issues right now, and all the other issues he has to deal with right now is Perry Platinum will be in action later on tonight. Regardless, right now, what's happening is Benjamin James working on Joe Hellenic here. This is what I'm talking about, that high-flying ability. Elbow drop to the spine. This is the quick ability that only a guy like Benjamin James can bring, but grounded quickly from Joe Hellenic. Look at this. Over something big. No, saw it again into another neck breaker. And this is the quickness that I'm talking about. That's that quickness that just may get him over in this match. Two. No. Those guys have to be thinking, what's next for me? What can I do next to really get things going for myself? And a Samoan drop just may have been that thing. One, two, no. Those that showed up once again. Hellenic was quick to throw Benjamin James just right over his shoulders and crash him to the mat with a Samoan driver. Samoan drop, sorry. Joe Lang does have a Samoan background and that Samoan heritage in him, running through his veins, but he needs more than a little bit of heritage to win this match. Regardless, he's doing a damn good job right now. Show me wrong. Now Benjamin James fights back with a shot of his own. Oh! Wouldn't expect it from a guy like Benjamin James, but he's bringing it. One, two, no, and again, throws that shoulder up. Smashing those elbows right across the temple, right across the head of Hellenic here. And I don't care how big or bad you are, you can ground someone, you can pull that off on someone, you can really get this match done ever so quickly. Watch this. Oh my gosh, Hellenic fights out of that with a fucking, holy shit. This guy is fucking amazing. This is the damage this guy can do. The damage this guy can do is insane. Sets up, kicks him in session, tries to break him off. Oh, cuts him off. But no, Benjamin James with the quickness still. You gotta believe that the fact that he powered out of that, out of nowhere, it just shows how good Hellenic is. Miss. Look at this, German suplex, German suplex, he got all of it from the top rope there. That's tossing a big 200 plus pound man across the ring. But Benjamin James, no small guy in his own right, and just may have this match over, but no, throws that shoulder up. Throws that shoulder up at the last moment. This is Joe Hellenic. Hellenic staying this thing, Benjamin James staying this thing. Like I said, Benjamin James is the kind of guy who likes to fly high, for sure. Going for something big, going for something big. It's a thought he was, now he's taunting Joe Hellenic here. Regardless of such, you gotta watch out for a guy like Benjamin James. Oh, diving clothesline there. Hopping up Hellenic for whatever. Oh! Hellenic didn't like that. Hellenic didn't like that drop kick. And Benjamin rolls out of the ring. Benjamin rolls out of the ring. Tosses the big man down. Oh! But now Benjamin James fights back with his own technical ability that he has. I told you, you can't count this guy's technical prowess in this match at any point in any point in time. And now really starting to show Hellenic what I'm talking about right here. The experience advantage just may be going his way right now. Sets up, he pops him out of that corner. German suplex. Benjamin has to keep the damage up on this guy, Hellenic. Hellenic's very durable, unlike Benjamin James. And like I said, Benjamin James has the experience advantage, has the speed advantage at points, has that unpredictable strength advantage as well sometimes too. Oh, but a clothesline like that will take you down quickly. Will take you down ever so quickly. And now Hellenic setting up. I don't know if anyone's seen this before, but he likes to go for a spear from the fucking middle rope. I mean, sorry, from the outside here. He got all of it. He got all of that. And ladies and gentlemen, this one could just be over. This one could just be over here. Sets up for something, but no. Saw coming a mile away. And now. Now look at this. Oh, release Tiger Suplex. Are you kidding me? This guy is moving. This guy is moving here. Oh. Oh, a headbutt out of fucking nowhere. Benjamin James got cracked there with that hard headbutt of Joe Hellenic. Oh, fist drop. Drops it right across the face of Benjamin James. Benjamin's still trying to, you know, Benjamin wants to fight and get back into this thing. You know he wants to get back into this thing. But it's just not happening. It's just not happening here. Regardless of such, now Benjamin has the, oh, caught him with that European uppercut. Sets up that teardrop. He got all of it. You can see he was setting up for that one. And James wants to finish. Wants to finish that jumping. Oh! Oh my gosh. Kick to the midsection. Fucking hey, these guys are going, and I'm loving this. Is when you get a top prospect tournament match like this, you know these guys want to be the best of the best. Whether you're wrestling for a year, whether you're wrestling for 2 years, whether you're a guy like Benjamin James has been wrestling for a good five. At this point, this guy's been doing damage. He's doing damage quickly. This is what I'm talking about right here. Benjamin James fights out of that one. You saw the way he threw that shoulder up. He knew exactly when he was going to kick out there. He didn't want to rush into it. But regardless, now you see again Benjamin James working the head of Joe Hellenic there. And you see the blood already flowing down the face of Hellenic after that vicious elbow. It just opened him up. Look at that. Oh, smart man. That was smart. That was smart on Hellenic's part. That was smart on Hellenic's part. Now you see Hellenic flying to the top here. Look at this. Oh, he takes him out with that bad elbow of his own. Hellenic wants to finish it, it seems. Hellenic wants to finish it, seems. Oh, shot, but no, Benjamin saw it again. Oh, trying to beat him to the punch with that kick, but Benjamin cuts him off with a kick of his own. European uppercut. Another one. That one cracks him down. That one cracks him to the mat. And now Benjamin can do whatever he wants to do. That jumping complete shot he likes to go for, even go for an ankle lock. The way, if you're a guy like Hellenic, you gotta watch your legs. You gotta watch your legs. That's for damn sure. Benjamin again fighting back once again and again and again. Look at this. But Hellenic just again tosses him off. Taunting him to get up, and this just may be over right here. Sets up, watch this, go! What authority, that could be it right there. One, two, three, and this one is over. Regardless of how you wanna look at that shit, However, we want to look at that match. Those two brought it at their best. Like I said, if you're in the top prospect tournament, this isn't your last time you're going to see these guys in action. Never, never that. I would never have these guys do a one-off. These guys, you may see these guys in action again in the future, whether against each other, whether they're teaming up with each other. You never fucking know. But regardless of such, I said that so much, but regardless of such, these guys brought it here, and it showed exactly what I mean here in wrestling, that this is a constant evolution in wrestling. It's a constant evolution of these guys constantly bringing new moves and bringing new ways to get things done. These guys went back and forth for so long, but it wasn't until this move right here made the finish. Could have been it, and Benjamin could have easily kicked out, but I think he dropped him just with enough authority and just with enough force to knock this man out. Referee tending to Benjamin James here, and Hellenic with a big time victory here for himself. Up next, we got some more action here on Pure Test Wrestling as we continue this UK tour. We got some females in action up next, so get ready for that here on Pure Test Wrestling. Intense wrestling. These girls get it going. Vicky Ron takes on Ruby Nix. Ruby Nix from Wales here, so very close to home for sure. This girl, and already with that fucking flapjack right there, already taking her down. But Ruby Nix, no joke in this ring, can bring it to the best of them. One of the best that they say she's easily one of the best. And I said, hey, let's give her a shot. Let's see what she can do here. Spinning back kick right there. Kick right to the leg. Another spinning back kick right there. Oh, tries to catch her. You saw her try to kick that leg out. Vicky having none of it. At the same time, let's address the elephant in the room. Lena Zada at the bottom. And she came out here with Ruby Nixon. I don't think Ruby Nixon needed any kind of help. She's small, but I don't think she needed any help necessarily. If you compare the sizes, Vicky Veron and Ruby Nixon, just about the same size. Vicky Veron, it's a little bit taller by a couple inches than Ruby Nixon. But regardless, this is not going to be a one-sided match by any means. Not by any means. It's probably the biggest challenge that Vicky Veron's had so far. But at the same time, like I said, Lena Zada on the outside. And it feels like she seems like she's on the side of Ruby Nixon here. The question is she on the side of Ruby Nixon? Or is she just trying to get in the head of Vicky Veron? Vicky Veron attacking Ali Carino. Comes to go. The last Pure Test Wrestling of last month. Ever since then, it's just been running a dominant streak of havoc. Oh! But now, this is where things start to turn around. For Ruby. This is what she wanted to do. Oh, missed that Enziguri shot there. Missed that Enziguri shot right there. And now, look at this. It's pulling on that hair. She's about to a five count until she gets disqualified. And Vicky Veron is no slouch in this ring. She's not new to wrestling at all by any means either. She's been doing this for years now. And she still looks damn good at what she does. And she's looking damn good. But regardless, like I said, Lena Zada on the outside. That's got to be getting the head of Vicky Veron here. At the same time, why did she attack Ali Carino a couple weeks ago? I have no fucking idea. Ooh. These girls are back and forth. This is what I like to see. Oh! Andrade again and again trying to get something going. These girls are back and forth here. This is what I like to see. Oh, clothesline there. Just may have taken the breath out of Ruby Nixon ever so quickly and now raking the eyes there. Fucking A. Ruby Nixon in trouble. Vicky Veron ever so just fucking ruthless in this ring. Look at that kick to the back. I mean, she has guarded shoes on. Imagine kicking them back with those guards like that. Oh, misses that. Hits all that butt to the ground. And now Ruby Nixon trying to get something going. I don't think she knows exactly her plan. Oh, trying to get the leg of Vicky Veron here. Oh, shot right there to the face. Another jab. Another one. Trying to get something going. Vicky Veron says no into a German suplex. Like I said, be the already easily the biggest challenge that Vicky Veron has had ever since debuting here in Pure Intense Wrestling a couple weeks ago. He didn't even know who she was. I mean, she's still somewhat mysterious. I've known she's wrestled for a very long time back in the States, but we don't know much of her. We don't know why she's here, why she attacked Ali Carino, and why even Lina Zana's out here, not Ali Carino. And I think she wanted to have Lina Zana do some scouting. But regardless, Ruby Nixon in control here. Like I said, I don't think she needed Lina Zada, but you know, Lina Zada out here just to play some mind games with Vicky Veron. Clothesline taking over. Vicky Veron here. Ruby Nixon ready to fly. Watch this. Oh! She cleared those ropes. This girl stands at about a good 5'6", 5'7", I believe. And she cleared those ropes with ease. Tossing them back into the ring. And some speed, close on once again. If you're Vicky Veron, you gotta be thinking, what the hell do I have to do? Because that Michinoku just may have taken me out. One, two, no. Throws that shoulder up if it does Vicky. Vicky Veron doing work. Oh, you saw the way she was getting up. She was setting up for something. Catches her with that Argentine. This could be it right here. Argentine side slam just may have done it. RGC side slam just may have done it. Watch this. Leg drop right there. I think trying to get into the head of Lina Zada here. And Ruby Nixon throws that shoulder up at one. Ruby Nixon right back up and into it. Taunting her. Think she doesn't want any part of what's going on. Referee backing her away. Clothesline takes her down. Another one there. That's the line. Super kick to the side of the head. Telling Vicky to get up, and Vicky, after taking that shot, you expect her to stay down, but the girl doesn't know how to, and now cross arm breaker. Ruby Nixon has that UK style strain, that British wrestling in her. She has it in her, and she just made Vicky Veron tap out here in a matter of seconds. The arm taking a lot of work in this one as this move is held on. Imagine someone pushing all their weight and pulling with all their strength on that single arm there, and the rest of your body can't go anywhere. You can't really move. The best thing you could do is wiggle out of it, and a girl like Vicky Veron can get out of a move like that a lot easier than some other females because of the strength she has. Regardless, now look at this. Look at that arm drag there. Oh, kick to the midsection. Catches her. Oh, European uppercut. Setting up for something. I think she's going for that widow's peak. No, cuts her off quickly. Ruby Nixon sets up. Stunner. She got all of it. Ruby Nixon on fire here. Telling her to kiss it. Takes her out. Trying to get that shiny wizard. The shiniest wizard of all belongs to a girl named Ruby Nixon, and she wants to end this match right here. This could be it. One, two, no, and Vicky throws that shoulder up. Vicky throws that shoulder up at the last second. Just when Ruby had things going for herself, throws that shoulder up at the last second, and if you're Ruby Nixon, you got to think to yourself, what the hell do I have to do? What the hell do I have to do? Because right now, she just kicked out of my the best move I have in my arsenal. And the best move in her arsenal, maybe the best move that she can pull off here to try and get one on Vicky, but Vicky just a little too experienced and too strong. Leg lariat from the second. Stumped right on the face. And right now, if Ruby didn't need help from Lina Zada before, she just may need a little intervention right now. Look at this. That's the strength. This is the strength of Vicky Veron here. Look at that power bomb. My goodness. Oh. Again, that sidewalk slam. That Argentine sidewalk. Kicks her right in the fucking face there. Set for something. Who would have counted Rana there from Vicky Veron? This girl is quick as hell. Doof. Catches that foot. Throws her down. Now setting up for a Boston Crab here. Boston Crab being locked in right now. Ruby fights out of it. Oh, misses that kick to the back. That's like she saw it coming a mile away. She saw it coming a mile away. Now look at this. No way. Ruby Nixon fights out of it once again. The hell is she up to? Look at this. Electric chair drop there. We find to the top. Who knows what she has planned? Or who knows what she has in store here for Vicky? Vicky's slowly being told to get up. And now she's slowly getting up. Now Ruby Nixon ready to fly. Spinning heel kick from the top rope. That was amazing. That was simply amazing. That was simply amazing. Now, locking in that cross arm breaker again. She got all of it. You can see the way she was setting up that she was ready to lock in that cross arm breaker. This could be all it right here. This could be all it right here. But again, Vicky Verón again, and using and learning as she goes in this match with Ruby Nixon here. Kick to the leg, shiniest wizard of all. She got it. Who knows what she has this door? Oh my gosh. Vicky Verón with everything she has just may be out of this thing here. 2, 3, this one is over. Ruby Nixon with a big victory here. And if you don't think for a second that Lena Zada got into the head of Vicky Verón, go back when she did the leg drop. She looked right at Lena Zada on the outside and hit her leg drop. That's Lena Zada's finisher, using all that weight to crash right across the throat of her opponent. And you saw Vicky do the same exact thing as she ran at her, and it tells you that she got into the mind of her. Even if it was for a second, that's all that Ruby Nixon needed. It was a second, and a second was all she needed to crack this move out of right there, that flip pile driver. And she just got a big time victory over a much more experienced Vicky Verón here. Anyway, with all being said and done, we got some more action for your asses tonight, you guys. But a great debut for this girl. I'd love to see what this girl can do in action as the year goes on, and hopefully maybe championship victory for this girl. You never know what to expect. Anyway, guys, up next, like I said, some more action for your asses here when we return to Pure Intense Wrestling. Cameron Moore takes on Lloyd Daniels here. Cameron Moore says he will not die. Experience goes towards Cameron Moore here for sure. Lloyd Daniels, though, spent a lot of time in the indies doing his thing in previous promotions, known as the American Dragon. The American Dragon here in the UK, it's going to be something big. But regardless, at the same time, Cameron Moore is no joke. Has the size advantage, and like I said, the experience advantage here for sure. The quickness will definitely go towards Lloyd Daniels, but he has to figure out to get that quickness and that submission styling around Cameron Moore. Cameron Moore says he will not die, but he just may tap out here by the end of it. Cameron Moore, like I said, using that advantage, that experience advantage, to really get one over and play around, and kind of have the opportunity right now to play around with a guy like Lloyd Daniels if he really wants to. And I know it sounds crazy, and he's saying, oh, Lloyd Daniels has no skill. No, it's experience in this one here for sure. But at the same time, Cameron Moore has to watch out for the quickness of Lloyd Daniels. And Lloyd Daniels is showing exactly what I'm talking about right here. Clothesline takes over Cameron Moore. Oh, he got his head, almost got caught between both of those fucking, these tables here. That could have been a bad day. Oh, for a guy like Cameron Moore. Flips out of that ever so quickly. Goes for a German suplex. You see the way he's locking it in, and he gets all of it. That's the quickness I'm talking about from a guy like Lloyd Daniels. That's the quickness I'm talking about from a guy like Lloyd Daniels. You can do things like this. You can do things like this cover so quickly and keep you down. And you won't even wonder, you'll be wondering how the fuck I got in this position. Oh, chopped to the chest. And that may have not really done too much damage to a guy like Cameron Moore, but think of this. He's wearing a shirt and it's wet. It's a wet shirt, right? That's a stinger right there, if anything. And not in wrestling world of a stinger, because that's just unfortunate. But that's a sting to the chest right there. And now Lloyd Daniels, oh, was getting something going, but those shots from Cameron Moore just floored Lloyd Daniels there, and it had him groggy for a moment. Watch, oh my gosh, look at this. He catches the arm. He has his arm held, and now you see the reversal there. Oh, and Drux kicks him right in the chest. and a dropkick right to the face. And Lloyd Daniels on top of the world here. If you're a fan of indie wrestling, this guy Lloyd Daniels knows all about it. Has spent time doing that. Kick to the midsection, toss it up to the top. Lloyd, I don't know what the hell he's up to. But I'll tell you what, whatever he wants to do, it's not gonna be good for a guy. Oh! No! Oh. He tosses him off. And now you see Cameron Morris at the top. Staying at the top here. Watch this corkscrew move. Sorry, corkscrew senton right across the chest. Cameron Morris trying to get things going and get things back in his favor. This is what this kid needs to do. Both these guys young in their age, but like I said, the experience goes towards Cameron Moore. And now Cameron Moore with the elbow right across the chest. Has to use that size advantage he has. Has to use that high flying ability that he has too. Don't let his size fool you. The guy may be standing around what a good 6'1", 6'2", but Cameron Moore can fly up to the top rope with ease. You saw him do that corkscrew senton just a moment ago. He can pull off moves. He can do things. And if he can lock in, if he can hit that leg drop from the top or anything of that sort, that side effect, he just may have in the back. Oh, but Lloyd Daniels fights out of that. Oh, oh. And now has him locked in to the lapel lock right now. The lapel lock right here. Holy shit, this could be it. What a submission hold here. Almost a modified crossface. But I don't think this is over just yet. But it easily could be. Easily could be over. You see Cameron Moore trying to fight out of this, trying to get towards those ropes, but has the advantage and tosses him off. Oh, kick right to the midsection. You saw him get tossed across the ring with that shot. And now, Cameron Moore stomping a fucking mud hole into Lloyd Daniels here, and now locking in a camel clutch right now. But do close to those ropes to do anything too special, and you see him as he reaches the ropes. And now, Cameron Moore, the man who says he will not die, may just have things going for himself here. Close and takes him down. Another one there. A third clothesline there. And now it's set up in the corner. This is Cameron Moore's opportunity to do whatever the hell he wants to do. This cross body right there. Beautifully done. Sets up perfectly. You see the positioning. The positioning for everything he does. He wants to do everything almost just so amazingly. And now a leg drop right across the chest. You see him feeling for it. You see him feeling for the chest. You see him feeling for the chest. And now cracks the elbow right across the head of Lloyd Daniels here. And Lloyd Daniels just may be finished. Lloyd Daniels just may be finished after this one. Watch this. Watch this. Sets up. Twist of fate. Twist of fate. And he got all of it. That could be it. That could be it right there. Hooks the leg on Lloyd Daniels. This could be it. One. And did I mind you? This is the last two participants to enter in for next week's Top Prospect Tournament. I know I've waited. I forgot all about it. I'm so fucking excited to see these guys go in action here. And Lloyd Daniels just gets cracked. Lloyd Daniels just gets cracked. Oh. Oh, and misses it. He went for it. Something big and gets it hits the ground hard. And you see Cameron Moore, not dumb by any means. He knows that Lloyd Daniels wants to get something going for himself and stops himself from rolling back in the ring. Stops himself from rolling back in the ring. And that is what's going to stop him. But I don't think that's going to stop Lloyd Daniels. He always has another way. He has another plan up his sleeve. Clothesline there from Cameron Moore, though. Takes him down with authority and goes for the hook of the leg. One. Two. No. Throws that shoulder up at two. 2.999, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, a kick right to the face. I think he caught the edge of his foot right across the fucking forehead, and it just may have just knocked out Lloyd Daniels here. And look at Lloyd Daniels, and no, oh, he stomped right into the chest. Cameron Moore not dumb by any means necessary. This is the kind of guy you gotta watch out for. Groggy as all hell, tossing him into the corner from pillar to post right now. Oh no. Has him at the top. This could be bad. For your Cameron Moore right now, you have everything going your way. You have everything going your way right now. Look at this. Double underhook. Look at this. Double underhook right here. Oh my gosh, across. Almost a butterfly suplex from the top. That's amazing. A top rope butterfly suplex. The avalanche butterfly suplex. You see Cameron Moore going to the top again. He knows opportunities don't come all the time. And he has a chance to win the Top Prospect Tournament here. Hit that leg drop, kid. Oh, he misses it. He misses it all. Lloyd Daniels, look at this. Oh, And Cameron Moore reverses out of that. I think Lloyd Daniels is going for that. Lloyd Daniels is going for that. That dance is special. No. He almost goes into an underhook of his own. And he locks in that arm. And right now, these two on the outside, and this is where things can get dangerous. If both these guys can't get back in the ring before the count of... No! If they both can't get back in the ring, the count of fucking 10, both these guys don't make it onto the next round. Oh, tosses him into the corner. Again, just toss him into that barricade there. Gosh, he hit that hard. Did you see the way he hit that? That wasn't nice. That wasn't nice at all. The way he hit that was not nice, and you gotta be wondering what the hell is Cameron Moore's arms, sorry, not arms, his body's feeling like after hitting those, that barricade multiple times and hitting those, the edge of that step and bouncing off that apron right there. This hammerlock clothesline, and he got all of it. This guy's so damn good at being good. Cameron Moore is good at being good, but so is Lloyd Daniels. And like I said, if I was so excited, I almost forgot to tell you guys all about that. Here we go, look at this. No, Lloyd Daniels says no. Lloyd Daniels says no. Look at this. Going for it again. But Cameron Moore sucks. Come on, once again. Rolls out of the ring again, does Lloyd Daniels. Both these guys are fucking good at being good. I'm telling you. Oh, you see him playing with his leg right there. Oh, shot right there to the fucking face. Lloyd Daniels at the top ever so quickly, as quick as he possibly can. Cross body, hooks the leg on Cameron Moore. Is enough, referee. 1, 2, no, and throws that shoulder up again, does Cameron Moore. Lloyd trying to get things going. This kid's trying to get something going for himself. DDT has worked his ass off to get to this point. Cameron Moore working his ass off to get to this point. You see the back and forth reversals. These guys don't know how to fucking slow down by any means. They keep going for him. Shot right there to the face. Lloyd Daniels once again. Oh, misses that knee. Off the ropes there. The quick turn's knocking him. Look at this cravat. Cravat neck breaker. Sorry, cravat suplex. What am I talking about? Either way. Oh, European uppercut. Ropes, ducks down, goes for something big. Cameron Moore stuck him all the way, kick to the back hamstring there, tossed him into the corner, elbow right there to the fucking mush. Oh, back elbow to the mush to be more exact. Oh, European uppercut takes him off his game. If you didn't know Lloyd Daniels before, you gotta know this guy has so many moves up his fucking repertoire. It's just as many as Cameron Moore does. And like I said, the experience goes towards Cameron Moore, but he cracks him with that shot right across the face. This could be it right here. 1, 2, 3. And I thought that was it. I thought that was the last we've seen of Cameron Moore in this tournament. But proves me wrong at kicking out at the last second. To the leg, and these guys are so damn, you gotta be wondering, like, who's gonna make it. Oh, sidewalk slam there. Close leg once again is enough. Pulls that shoulder up at 1, does Lloyd Daniels here. See him wrenching again at that jaw and just pulling at that jaw, trying to slow down the pace of Lloyd Daniels here. Cameron Moore trying to get things going, and again going up to the top, and this could be the end of the match right here. If he can hit, this leg drop, it just may be over. Oh, he gets all of it. Stomping right on the chest a second time there. After hitting that leg drop, you think he'd go for the pin, but just wants to do more, it seems. And now punching his fucking lights out right there. Will strikes. Close to leg again. Referee, oh. Lloyd has so damn resilient. Cameron Moore has been wondering, what the hell do I have to do? And Cameron Moore at the top again. I don't know what his plans are, but I'll tell you this. It's not going to be good if you're a guy like Lloyd Daniels, because Cameron Moore can do so much from the top rope. Go! No way! Oh, that backbreaker! He caught him out of midair. Lloyd Daniels is no big guy. You're catching a guy the size of Cameron Moore, but that may have been the last straw right there. But I may have been wrong. Kick to the, oh. Pulls him down again. sets up that Boston Crab, but I think it was out of desperation there. I think it was out of desperation because he gets a rope break. He gets that rope break. Toss him into the corner. Oh, and back elbow once again. Ooh. Punch right back and forth. Sets up that Regal-esque neck breaker. And someone who's trained guy like Lloyd Daniels and who's gained that training is a guy like William Regal. Trained a lot of the guys like you saw last year's season mode, and this could be it. You see it, that desperation has to be setting in now. Lloyd Daniels may be out of this thing. Calls it as it is, but throws that shoulder up again. If you are Karen Moore, if you are Lloyd Daniels, you gotta be wondering which one of us is gonna walk out of this thing, because we want this so much. And this is just the first round for these guys. One of these guys will be taking on Joe Hellenic next week, I promise you that. And you gotta be wondering, who is that gonna be? If they're gonna be 100% by the end of it. Lloyd Daniels rolls to the outside. This runs back in the ring. Oh, misses it, jumps over. Oh, I think he was trying to do a little, try to show off a little something or something. Forearm shot right there. And you saw Karen Moore a second away, and I mean a second away from doing whatever the hell he wanted to do. I think he was trying to go for that twist of fate. Oh! Stomped around on the back. And rolls out once again as Lloyd Daniels. Lloyd Daniels so quick and using it and utilizing that speed that he has. Kick to, caught him first, tossed him into the corner again. And again, right to the eye. Tosses him over. Lloyd Daniels, this could be his last opportunity. Lost in this dancing special again, but no, Cameron Moore, third time in a row, saw it coming. He rolls out of the ring once again. Arguing with the crowd here saying no. And dancing, playing a little dirty. You gotta do it. Like I said, sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. Into the corner, it's gonna be all him. Almost got him, but no. I think he was trying to pull that twisted fate from the top. That neck breaker from the top. But Lloyd Daniels says, no, it ain't happening. Not to me. European uppercut. This match is insane. European once again. Reversal once again. Both back and forth. This thing may never end. These guys just may damn near kill each other. And this thing may never end for either of these guys here. And if you wanted a match, you got one. If you wanted a match, you got one. Here in Pure Intense Wrestling, maybe the best match of the night, all hands down. And that's just maybe now hands down the truth. I told you, these guys want this so damn much. Oh! And you heard the cracking. The cracking of Cameron Moore's spine as he collides into that barricade on the outside. This could be all Lloyd Daniels right here. Instead of going for something a little different. Those kicks to the chest again and again, and it cracks him right aside of the head. Tell Cameron Moore to get up. Cameron Moore may be out of this thing. Lloyd Daniels going for that shot right across the face once again. Is it enough this time? Referee, 1, 2, 3, and this one is over. You can say what you want to say about either of these guys, but they brought it, and they brought down the house here tonight. I don't care what you say. These guys brought it. Every time you try to go for that dancing special, Cameron was there and ready to get out of that. You see him with this leg drop multiple times here tonight. Missed it at that last opportunity. And here we saw once again trying to get something going. Reverses out of that. How many times he tried to lock him into that twist of fate from the middle. From the corner. Cross him again of second time in a row. Getting himself that fucking opportunity to take on Joe Hellenic next week. But now you're going to be thinking, how hurt is this guy? How hurt is a guy like Lloyd Daniels, and how is he gonna fare going on against Joe Hellenic next week? We'll find out soon enough, won't we? But anyway, guys, someone watching for your asses up next, as the Hardcore Championship, the Pure Intense Wrestling Hardcore Championship to be more exact, is on the line. When you see who gets the shot at that championship, you gotta be thinking, it just may be him. But anyway, we'll see. I'll show you guys what I'm talking about up next here on Pure Intense Wrestling. Welcome back to Pure Intense Wrestling. Samson Crane takes on Remy Cross, and already fucking Remy with a big time fucking jumping complete shot there. This match just started, and already Samson Crane fights back though already. This is for the Pure Intense Wrestling Hardcore Championship, and these guys know that that means so much for guys, for these two here for sure, but it means more for Samson Crane. Samson Crane not winning, getting eliminated in the first round, last week in the Pure Intense Wrestling, top prospect tournament. And I said, hey, he did a great job last week. Let's give this man a shot. Let's see what this guy can do. Let's see what this guy can do in action for the Pure Intense Wrestling Hardcore Championship. And at the same time, when you think about this, think about this as well. Samson Crane's a big fan of a guy like Remy Cross, a guy who helps promote the smaller guys, a pioneer of sorts, a hardcore legend, some would even say. And with that being said and done, we saw Remy Cross defeat. We saw Remy Cross defeat Psycho Nemeth last week, the Pure Intense Wrestling Hardcore Championship, and I'm pretty sure Psycho Nemeth always wants to fight back that Hardcore Championship. He did it all last year as well, against Big or Bad. It didn't matter who it was. All right, now Samson Crane fighting back with these shots, chopped to the chest there, elbow right there, goes for a bulldog, takes him down. Oh my gosh, in his head, you saw the way he drove his head right through the fucking mat right there. Two, those that showed up, there's Remy Cross. I'm gonna switch in and get in a hardcore match. You're gonna just get hard hitting. There's the only way you can win this thing is by pinfall submissions inside the ring. Outside means nothing. But anything can happen in a hardcore match. You may see people go through tables at any moment. You may see guys get just cracked through and with everything. And right now, look at this. Go, gory fucking face buster there. You see him slowly getting up. You saw him slowly getting up, and Remy just cracks him right back down. Now stumping on that spine. Oh. Oof. Oh, knee to the midsection. Another one right there. Drop kick, and this guy Samson Crane is bringing it. And whether you like or hate this guy, you gotta give him credit for standing in here in a match with Remy Cross and really having one over Remy Cross right now, not having that advantage. At the same time, maybe Samson has that advantage. Maybe Samson has that advantage that specifically over Remy Cross is simply because the guy has been in matches, has watched this guy as a young kid. Oh, it just cracks him right across the face. You see him throw his whole body, and this is what he'll do. He'll throw his whole body in harm's way to win this match. He'll throw his whole body in harm's way to win this match. And now taking out the table here, it's just the classic hardcore match you're going to see here on Pure Intense Wrestling. Oh! Knee to the midsection. Drops, kicking, swatted away. Kick to the midsection there from Remy. Sets up. Oh, running bulldog. What the hell does he have? What else does he have planned? I mean, these guys are getting everything but the kitchen sink right now. And now that candlestick being brought out. Oh, right across the back. Right across the back with that shot. And now you see Remy just doing everything he possibly can. Samson Crane's taking so much damage already in this match, but so is Remy Cross. Toss him here. Thuddies hits the ground here. Trying to cut himself off from before hitting those steps. It's the same thing, from Cameron Moore earlier on. And an amazing match versus Lloyd Daniels. You talk about top prospect guys. Samson Crane, top prospect guy last week. And like I said, lost it. But now has the opportunity. Now has the opportunity to take on a guy, a hero of his, being Remy Cross. Clothesline takes him over. If you're Remy Cross right now, you would think, what the hell is this kid up to? Because this, whatever contraption he's putting together doesn't look good. And I think he's trying to challenge Remy Cross up to the top. Oh my gosh. Oh, shit. Are you kidding me? Oh, no. And not much space to go. Not much space to go. Remy Crush just got tossed off and almost with that table there. Oh no, it was almost in an elbow. He elbowed that table. He elbowed that table. And now the ladder in hand. Now ladder in hand. Oh. For him to move so quickly in that little bit of space that he had, and then for Samson to crash, oh my gosh, for Samson to crash right into that fucking this table here, with the cover on and everything, the damage could easily have been done. The damage easily could have been done. This guy is so damn out of it. Samson Crane just so fucking out of his mind too. He'll do whatever he has to do to win. And right now you see Samson turn up the fire here. I don't know what the hell that was all about. Oh, oh my gosh, no. No. It's funny for a second, Samson, but you gotta stop this kid. You gotta stop this. Oh no. Whoa, gets out of that. Gets out of that. Remy Cross setting up for a spiral bomb, and he got all of it. Is it enough, referee? 1, 2, no. Throws that shoulder up. Remy needs now the now needs to get opportunity to get things going for himself. You see Samson Crane trying to meet him back in the ring. Remy Cross has nothing left in him. Oh, a chop to the chest once again. But no saw coming a mile away. Oh, jumping complete shot once again. Remy Cross maybe running on fumes here, but so maybe Samson Crane. Misses that leg drop. Oh, that big boot right there could have done it. Oh, he cracked him again. And that time he got all of it. He got all of it. He got all of that shot. That was ruthless. When I'm talking, like I said, that is ruthless. And that shot cracked him. That basically got him. Oh, jawbreaker right there. No, Samson says no. Whatever the hell that Remy Cross is going for, Samson says no. It ain't happening to me. You're not doing that to me again. Whatever the hell you were thinking. Remy Cross fights back. DDT there. From the angle. You can't really see it. Throws a shoulder up. I believe Samson Crane is bleeding here from what we see here at the announcer table. And now just, ooh. Takes him down there with that reverse DDT and again cuts him off. Remy Cross can cough once again. And now, Samson Crane out of his mind. But no, I think Remy knows what Samson Crane is trying to go for. And now look at this. And again with that fucking that gory bomb there. This is Remy's opportunity to really turn this thing around, but no, cuts him off once again. And again, these guys with the back and forth is too real. Setting up, TKO coming up, he got all of it. Look at the face of Remy just busted open, and he's dripping like a fucking faucet here. And you see Remy trying to gather his things, gather his wits about him right now, but he's fucking hurt. He's hurt, and so is Samson Crane. And Samson Crane just may be out of this thing. Samson Crane just may be out of this thing. Ladies and gentlemen, no suck coming a mile away. Toss him. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no. What a match. You gotta be fucking kidding me. These guys are getting it going. And I'm loving this match right now. Remy Cross. Oh, what a clothesline. And again with the candlestick in hand, it cracks the spine. Cracking that spine. Once again with that candlestick. Those hurt. What does it take, ladies and gentlemen? What does it take? Elbow right across the spine. Stomp to the spine, just keeping the damage up. Oh, oh my gosh. And no Remy saw coming a mile away. Tosses him back into the ring, but what does Samson have in him? I think that was that last kick that he had was maybe the last thing he may have had in him. And now, no. he just cracks up his chest with that hand, almost like a frying pan, and goes flying. Samson Crane ready to fly with that elbow. These guys have beaten the hell out of each other. What does it take to win? I think he was thinking of something with a ladder, but now wants to do something even worse than that. And that's why he put Remy Cross through that same, through that table. Oh! What do you need to do to win a match like this? What can you do to win a match like this? Especially when you're Samson Crane. Look how much damage the kid has taken. And he's still going. He's still going. Oh, no. Oh, no. Remy, you gotta find your wits about you right now. Oh, no. Look at this. No way. Oh! If this was a false count anywhere match, maybe Samson Crane would have had this match in the bag. But you gotta think about this. He has to now take Remy Cross and get him back in the ring. How's he still standing is beyond me. No, that neck breaker. You know Samson Crane has something up his sleeve. You know Samson Crane has something up his sleeve. Watch this. Oh, Needham. But he's trying to go for it. I think he was trying to do something a little new. Something that was going to take Remy. That's something that was going to take Samson Crane off his game. And Samson Crane just got hit with the knee. He got hit with the knee. And that's got to disorient him a little bit. But Remy Cross, I don't think he was expecting to get that kind of torque off that. Oh, no. Samson Crane, watch out, kid. Oh, my goodness, no. You say this is awesome. Yes, it is. Ladies and gentlemen, oh my gosh, fucking Remy Cross. Remy Cross now setting up. Now setting up. Look at that suplex. No. Neck breaker. Holy shit. You gotta be kidding me. Clothesline there. Another one. That one was a forearm, if anything. From one pillar to another. Got him. Fucking bulldog. Fucking bulldog there. These guys are insane. And you weren't expecting this. I wasn't expecting them to go this far. And like I said, there's no hatred in this thing. This is hardcore wrestling. This is what you wanted. This is what people ask for all the time. We need some hardcore matches. We need things a little more extreme. Well, you got extreme here, and these guys just made damn near kill each other. Oh my gosh, that back elbow missed. That back elbow missed. Reversed it. Oh, stop coming a mile away. Stop coming a mile away. Oh, look at this. But Remy Cross reverses it. How does he do it? I think he knew that he was gonna try and drive him through that fucking ladder if he could. Drop kick to the side of the head. And that could be it. That easily could be it. Two. Oh, and throws that shoulder up. How close could that have been? And Samson Crane takes so much damage. I don't care about how good the kid is. That could easily have been a bad day for... Oh! Samson Crane. Samson Crane fights back, though. Look at this headlock driver. He got all of it. This guy is fucking lethal. This guy is something. This guy is special. And right now, Remy Cross fights back. Look at this TKO. Oh! And Remy just may be finishing this. Remy just may have finished this match. One. No! The crowd has to be screaming, this is awesome. They know how good this is. They know how good this is. They have to be thinking in their heads, this is an amazing match right now. You bring expecting Pinterest Wrestling to turn up like this, but this is what you're gonna get. But Remy Cross taking a little too much time. He needs to set up that fucking pile driver. He needs to set up for something, but no, Samson Crane says no. And then again, just may have it. He got all of it. Tope Atomico missed. Oh, gets that leg. Dragon Screw. You see him trying to get things going. No, but Remy cross cuts him off. What the hell? How are they doing this? How the hell are they doing this? This could be it right here. That gosh, that pile driver. He cradles him and just crashes him into the ground. Nowhere to go. This one's over. This one. I thought this was over. He kicked out at one. This man kicked out at one after taking a pile driver. Remy Cross has to be thinking, what the hell do I have to do? Samson Crane says no once again. Now he's going for those shots. Flying back with those shots and everything else in him. Everything you can fucking throw into him. Oh, tosses him over. Oh, he hits right on the edge of that step right there. And you see him still trying to fight back. He's still trying to fight back here. But you know the damage has been done. He has to realize the damage has been done here. The damage has been done. Oh! And he keeps doing more. Scaring the hell out of me because these guys are going to damn they be injured. I don't care how you say it. These guys are going to be hurt. And Samson Crane's taking so much damage. What's next for this kid? What's next for Remy Cross? What are they going to do? What's the next step? What's the next plan? Because right now, Remy Cross is down and out. Sorry, Samson Crane down and out. Spinning wheel kick. Back elbow there. Clothesline takes him down. Cracking him with these shots again and again. And from what I see on the camera here on the big camera, Remy Cross is busted open. Ladies and gentlemen, Samson Crane challenging Remy Cross again, or not at all. Oh my gosh, he got folded up end over end. This could have, that could, fucking A. These guys are bringing it. No, Remy Cross saw it coming a mile away. There's no hatred here. That's what I'm trying to tell you guys. There's no hatred here. It's almost like these guys have been knowing each other for so long. And Remy Cross has me thinking, hey, maybe Samson Crane knows a lot of the things I've done in the past. Has watched me on TV. He is the younger of the two. He knows this. Maybe Samson knows something that maybe knows a weakness that Remy Cross has, and right now, no. These guys are bringing it, and I'm loving it. Snapmare, and cracks him open again with that elbow. Cross again. Samson Crane again. Shot right there. Sets up. Look at this. Nowhere to go. Watch this. He cradles him right into it. This could be it right here. 2, 3. This one is over. Holy shit. We have a new Pure Intense Wrestling Hardcore Champion. These guys brought it here. I wasn't expecting this to be like this. We still have another match to go. This is a pay-per-view style fucking match. These guys proved again and again that hardcore wrestling can constantly keep evolving. They try to put each other through that table the whole time. They freaking beat the hell out of each other. So much. They did so much to get this thing going. They did so much. This match was insane. The back and forth just to get something going for each for themselves was insane. After all the damage he took, still kicked out. In the end, he hits him with this fucking electric chair into a driver right there and gets himself the 3. How did he do it is beyond me, but a big time victory here for Samson Crane. Holy shit. And now we have a new Pure Intense Wrestling Hardcore Champion. Dreams come true, I promise you that. Dreams come true, I promise you that. And I told you, if you're a top prospect, you're going to be in matches. You're going to be put in matches. Maybe you may not get the same luck that Samson Crane got in becoming Pure Intense Wrestling Hardcore Champion, but you will never be left behind, whether you win or lose this top prospect tournament. And then we got another match for you. We got another match for you up next in our main event. So don't you dare click away. This one's gonna get out of control. So our main event, I mean, we had an amazing night here so far, but this guy Nero Galaxian is always ready to get going, and I wanna see what this guy can do in action. Against a guy like Perry Platinum, who, as of late, Perry Platinum saying, hey, well, he wants to be the guy. He wants to be the guy, the next guy to take on, whether it's the Pure Intense Wrestling, the current Pure Intense Wrestling world champion, James McGalloway, or the top prospect winner, whatever the hell that may be by the end of this thing. Says whoever wins at Marvelous, he'll be taking them on the week after. He wants championship gold. But he has to get through a lot of the bigger guys here in Pure Intense Wrestling. A lot of the guys that have been really running the show as of late. And Nero Galaxian isn't always on top. But best believe, a win over Nero Galaxian is huge. As we get this one started, you see the eyes of Nero Galaxian right there. And this man right here as well, Perry Platinum, makes his way down to the ring. And if you think for a second that this match is going to be anything less of a barn burner, you're out of your mind. Do you see the night we've had? Do you see the night we've had? It's going to get out of control. Perry Platinum, no dummy in this ring. Me and Nero Galaxian, both these guys that you could say they're Pure Intense Wrestling originals. Doing their thing for a while, and I just can't think of any better way for these two to kick some ass. Instead of just stepping in the ring and getting it done. And these guys are going to get it done here. Up next in our main event here on Pure Intense Wrestling. Welcome back to Pure Intense Wrestling. Nero Galaxian, Perry Platinum. Let's get this thing on the road. Perry Platinum already making steps ahead. Play that no dummy by any means, do it too. Making sure that Nero Galaxian not quick enough to outpace him here. Oh, and clobbers him down to the mat already. This guy's in a top collar and elbow tie up here. You know, Galaxian can get into the head of Perry Platinum. I mean, you can really throw Perry Platinum off his game, but Perry Platinum's whole thing is, hey, I'm the smaller guy in most of my situations. I'm going to play dirty. I'm going to do whatever the hell I have to do to make sure I win this match. But Nero Galaxian, no joke here, already setting up for something. Look at this. Gourd Buster right there. Set out Gourd Buster. Probably blowing the chest of Perry Platinum out. That one. Take the breath out of you ever so quickly. Nero Galaxian's all about quickness and effectiveness. Oh, but Perry Platinum says no. Elbow to the back of the head. Oh, our knee right there. Clobbering him right back, right to the right down to the mat. And that's just that signature style elbow drop there from Perry Platinum. He turned this match back in his own favor. Arm drag reversal there by Nero Galaxian. Back in the headlock once again. We're gonna run him there from Nero. Nero being the bigger of the two. He needs to keep that size advantage going his way and get himself at angles that, you know, Perry Platinum I can't reach. But Perry Platinum's so damn good at it. I mean, it's hard to get that. It's kind of hard to get that thing going. It's kind of hard to get that, any of that momentum going when you have a guy like Perry Platinum always one step ahead of you. Perry Platinum ready to fly. Oh! Just showing off here as he's won the match already or something, but still. That's the speed that this guy brings. Forearm shot right there. Has him at the top. Ooh, chop right to the chest. Glasson already in trouble. And this match just practically started for these two. And already you see him at the top here for a superplex right here. Beautifully done. Perry Platinum, no dummy. since that last chance for you a little early in this match, but hey, it could do damage. It could do damage quickly. Do damage real quickly. But Nero still being the bigger two. Oh, the two just fucking lays a shot right into the top of the head of Perry Platinum here. Chop to the chest. Nero Glass, after all that, hits him with a side effect. Nero quickly, don't expect that a lot from a guy like Nero Galaxian to get something like that going, but he's so quick. And if there's not many people who can run up the corner and pop that kind of thing off like that, but if there's someone who can do it, it's definitely Nero Galaxian. Catch that enziguri right across the side of the head. Like a slapping sound. It's so damn painful sounding too. Mongolian chop there, another one. Chop right to the chest. Elbow right across the fucking smaller back. Not even a smaller back. What the fuck am I talking about? Oh, DDT there, but fucking by Nero Galaxian. Perry Platinum now. Like I said, when you're Perry Platinum and you say, hey, I'm gonna win everything I put myself into until I get a shot at that championship. I'm winning everything I'm put into. You gotta kind of believe him. At the same time, he may be just fucking spoke a little too much for what he wanted to do, and maybe speaking a little too much. And hey, sometimes you gotta just shut the fuck up and just go out there and talk less and make Galloway show them exactly what I was talking about. Look at this, Perry Platinum with a reversal. Perry Platinum reversal, but referee throws that shoulder up. Referee had taken too long, and it could have easily been a three, but I think that was referee's fault there. I think he saw the Nero's feet on the ropes, but had to take a second look. Oh, and speaking of looking twice, you better look out for Perry Platinum. Just cracked him there. Topi Atomico and still stays in this thing. Nero Galaxian stays in this thing. But these guys are beating the hell out of each other. These guys are beating the ever-living shit out of each other. Glass forearm shot right there. Another one. Sets up Sling Blade. Nero Galaxian has everything going his way. Look at this. Oh, no. Do you see him bounce off that second and first rope there? Notice that middle and bottom rope just caught nothing but Perry Platinum's face. And I think it also caught the throat too. But at this point, you really can't focus on that when you're getting worked on right now. And referee says he's still fine to compete. If not, he would have ended the match already. And now just doing work. Oh, it's Nero Galaxian. But Perry Platinum still fights back. That's what I mean. Perry Platinum has no give, because when he wants something so badly, he will fight for it. He will fight through injuries to get a shot at any title he wants to go for. Right now, his eyes are on that Pure Intense Wrestling World Championship. Perry Platinum, as good as he is, has never been champion of anything. He's always a top guy. He's always been top guy, but he's always in and out in Pure Intense Wrestling. He's always going. He's always making the switch to Crash Japan or going back. And it's that learning experience. I think it's gonna pay off for him soon enough. The question is, can he get through Nero Galaxian? Oh! The back and forth is too real here. Back and forth is too real here. Snap suplex there. Okay, floated over for a pin, but the desperation's starting to set in, and you see right there. See the desperation starting to set in as he missed that. Oof! You saw him when he hit him with that snap suplex. He kind of fell on one knee there, and that means that the pain's starting to add up here for Nero, and he's starting to run out of stamina. But a guy like Perry Platinum has a second and a third and a tenth wind, and he keeps coming back. He keeps coming back, and that's where Nero Galaxian may fall, but Perry Platinum may stand strong in this match. Oof! Gosh. Speaking of standing strong, watch out for Perry Platinum. This is the signature style Perry Platinum here. Ready to fly here. Look at the speed. Oh my goodness. And that's what Perry Platinum brings to this ring here. The speed, the athletic ability that everyone else out here in Pure Intense Wrestling or Crash Pimp Wrestling can bring. Just taunting the referee at this point. We're at a five, and Nero runs back into the ring. Perry Platinum getting a little speed from that corner. And look at that roll-up. Look at that roll-up. This could be the end of that match right here. One. No, one. No, only a one. But that could have been close. That could have been a bad day. That could have been a bad day for a guy like Perry Platinum here. Nero Glasser Raiders with a twist of fate. Twist of fate, and he got all of it. But I think even Nero knows that this match isn't over just yet. This match isn't over just yet. Side effects down style. Go up to the top, and this could be the opportunity that he needs. That Swanton is calling, and it's telling Nero Glasser on the high fly, baby. No! We may have told him a little too much. Oh, tried to go for the kick to the midsection. Gets cut off there. Elbow right there to the back of the head. Sets up for the brain buster. I believe he's setting up for it. Oh my gosh, he drops right on the top of his head. And without hesitation, goes right for the pin. Two. Throw, and I thought that was it. I easily would have thought that was it. If it was a lesser man, we thought that was it. But still stayed in it. Is in the Nero Glasser right now. Oh! Oh my gosh. Are you fucking kidding me? Kicked in the midsection after the long night we've had here tonight. These guys are going. And I'm loving every minute of it. Tosses him into the corner. Shot right to the chest. Close to the leg again. Like I said, out of desperation here. But Nero needs to show less desperation. It's just keep laying on more moves. Laying on more damage. Don't try to go for pins. Don't try and wear out Perry Platinum. Like I said, this guy can kick out of just about anything. He takes damage. He amplifies it. He takes it, he amplifies it, and he makes it his own. And he turns it back on you. It's like watching a video game or something. Oh, what kind of rana there from Nero. Oh, kick right to the fucking chest. Nero has opportunities. And now he's just set up. Oh my gosh, Perry Platinum. Oh my gosh. Are you kidding me? Sets up with a brain buster again here. He got all of it, my goodness. He's practically picking up dead weight at this point and going for another brain buster. And this one looks just as damaging as the last, and he has him in the air, letting all the blood flow to the head, and he crushes him down to the mat. Perry Platinum just laid out Nero Glaxion here, and this match still goes on. What else can this guy do? Clothesline takes him down. Another one there. A third one, and Nero still fighting back, but what does it take? Dropkick, oh, swatted the dropkick away. Reverses out of that. Oh! Just cracks him. Sit him back wondering. This Perry Platinum, what's my next step? What's my next thing gonna be? Because right now things are not going my way, not the way I expected them to go. Now tossing him into the corner once again. Trying to go for that. Oh, missed that drop kick once again. Tosses him into the corner. Nero Glaxion kicked to the midsection. Oh, went for the leg, smart man, but a little bit quicker on that exchange. This is Nero Glaxion's opportunity, whispering the win, and he gets all of it. Nero taunting, he needs to finish, he needs to cover, he needs to go for Twist of Fate, he needs to go for that Swanton, he needs to get something going. If he can get a win over Perry Platinum and shut the mouth of Perry Platinum, that would be amazing here. That would be something that everyone wants. Right now, Perry Platinum on top of the world, just being in this match with a guy like Nero. And kicking out at the last second there, but wasting too much time to Nero. And now Nero going to the top one more time. Is it enough here? Ladies and gentlemen, is it enough here? Swanton bomb, and he gets all of it. Hooks the leg there on Perry Platinum. One. Ladies and gentlemen, a one count. Perry Platinum is here to win. Perry Platinum is here to do damage. Perry Platinum is here to fucking dominate. Don't let his size fool you. That guy is durable as all hell. And if anyone knows that, it should be Nero Glaxion. He should know this out of anyone. Elbow right across the chest one more time. Taunting him to get up, but how much left does he have in him? Tossing him to the corner again. Giraffe kick, he got him all that time. kick to the midsection, sets up with a brain buster one more time. Is it enough? Referee, quick, get ready to count, because this one just may be over. Goes on the hook of the leg and going for a dirty pin. The referee doesn't see it. One, two, throw. Nero throws that shoulder up at the last second. A knee right across the head. And now you see the slowdown there, the slowing down in the process of this match here. Oh my gosh, these guys are getting it. Going to the top one more time. Hopefully for the last time here tonight, going for it. Something big. 450 gets all of it. Hooks the leg on Nero. Is it enough? One, two. No, and Nero throws that shoulder up at two. I don't know what near Prairie Platinum has in store for Nero, but I'm telling you, it's not going to be nice. Drop kick there. How the hell is Nero still in this? He took, four brainbusters now? Oh, forearm shot. He's taking work in this match. He's taking a bunch of work in this match and still continues to stay in this thing. Tosses him into the corner once again, ready for getting thrown, ready for that whisper in the wind. Oh, chop to the chest. Oh. Up to the second rope here, goes for that diving clothesline. Oh, Perry Platt didn't like that. Forearm shot swatted. Sets up, throw that backbreaker. And I told you this is not going to be a nice match for these two. They're going to bring it their all. Nero Gillespie wants to shut the mouth of Perry Platinum. Perry Platinum wants to continue on and keep on improving. Keep on getting better. Keep on getting better. Rolls. Oh, no. Oh, oh. Oof. Sets up. He got all of it. He got all of that fucking inverted atomic drop there. Inverted atomic drop just crushed him. Right across, right almost in the grind, almost that's the whole spine being taken out there. Nero Galaxian tosses him into the corner one more time. For what? Oh, who knows? Kick, oh, cut the kick. Clothesline takes him down. This is fucking Nero's opportunity. This is Nero's opportunity. Drop kick to the side of the head. This is the kid's opportunity. These boys have been bringing it ever since the start of this match, and it's not going to change anytime soon. Oh! Forearm shot takes him down. And you know Platinum always has something else in store for anyone that he takes on. It doesn't matter about the size of the opponent. It's about the heart sometimes. And right now, the heart just may have been almost taken out right there from Perry Platinum. But Player Platinum gets caught up, but then reverses out of that. Some finds a way to counter out of that. And the guy's so quick. He does things like at this speed. Oh. Drop kick one more time. Kick right to the fucking midsection. Brain buster ready to set up. Ready to set up here. Oh, he got it again. How many brain busters does it take to take out a Nero Galaxian? I don't know. But Perry Platinum may just be trying to find out here. Two, three, this one is over. What a match. And what a night here on Pure Intense Wrestling. These boys brought it. I don't care what you say. If you count out Nero Gillespie ever again, you're damn it out of your mind. The guy can always come up out of nowhere, but just a little bit short tonight. This is the speed I'm talking about. Look at this. Throws that elbow right across the face. These guys brought it again and again. Just when you thought it was over, they stayed in it. They stayed in it again and again. It wasn't just Perry Platinum. It was Nero Gillespie as well. Just how many times did he hit that brainbuster before he ended it? He had to physically end it. And that other time he did the brainbuster before this one. This one was between the finishing blow. He used ropes for leverage. Referee didn't even see it. And at the same time, the man still kicked out. It shows that Nero Gillespie has resiliency. We've seen him in matches before last year. And we've seen Perry Platinum last year in action as well. But Perry Platinum's on a new route. And that route is a route to the Pure Intense Wrestling World Championship. You gotta be wondering what's in this guy's mind and who's next to take this mantle next week and who's gonna win that, who's gonna be winning the top prospect tournament. There's so much going on. We're here in the UK still doing this tour. I'll see you guys at Crash Man Pro Wrestling. Thank you guys for watching. I had to redeem myself from Crash Man Pro Wrestling's last episode. So hopefully Crash Band can tear shit the fuck up again this week. unlike last week. I hope we can get ourselves back into the role here. If you guys like this, please, as always, comment, like, and subscribe. All these things help me out so much. Share me out. The Wrestling Empire, all that stuff. I have all these links set up. If you like wrestling, if you want the best wrestling on the planet, then you come and check out my channel. I do it better than anyone else. I can promise you that. With that being said and done, like I said before, comment, like, subscribe, and I will see you guys at Crash Japan Pro Wrestling. Until then, peace out and good shit.